courses, right? So what is the problem we are trying to solve is the big problem of education in India. I think a lot of our panelists discussed that. Even Professor Mr. Gowda, who spoke, also brought this up. There are everybody agrees, I think, broadly that there are a lot of problems in education in India, right? I'm sure if I were to ask you how many of you think there is a problem in education in India, I think all the hands will go up, right? But what are the problems? There are broadly three problems that I can think of. One is access, right? Two problems. One, if you're from a tier three city or small village in India, there is a lot of access problem. You don't have access to quality education, right? Now, two is quality. Quality of education is also a big problem, right? For example, I come from I'm from Coimbatore, which is probably a tier two city. Now, if I have to learn something on a specific topic, like say selenium testing or something, I will not have the best person to teach, right? I will have to go to whoever knows selenium best in Coimbatore, which might not be the best way to learn that, right? So there is a quality problem. And third is affordability, right? Education, quality education in India today, if we were to learn the latest technology, I probably look at a course from abroad, which for Indians is pretty expensive, right? So that's the third problem. Now, we are trying to attack all three problems, but mostly two and three. We are attacking the quality problem as well as, I would say, quality and relevance, and also the affordability problem. Now, if I were to look at existing solutions, now online learning is not new, right? It has been there for a while now. But the current online learning, if you look at massive online open courses and the Courseras of the world, they are current existing educational systems, but made online, right? That's pretty much what it is. Traditional education system just converted, put online. What we are trying to do is something very different. We are looking at very practical education. You learn skills that you use every day from somebody who uses it every day in a better way, right? Something you learn from an expert who's already doing it, right? So those kind of things is what we're looking at. Now, there are two things that I want to highlight on this. One, again, are we the only one doing it? Now, broadly, Udemy is doing it to an extent. I'll talk about how the market is currently, who are the players, and how we're different later. I also want to talk about, there is a lot of content, right? Now, if you want to know something, what do you do? You come across something new. If you want to know more about it, you typically go and search on Google, you go to Wikipedia and look for it, right? Now, that's about knowing, right? If you want to learn something, where do you gently go? And we want to be that place. We want Chalk Street to be the place where you go if you want to learn something. Like the Wikipedia for knowledge, we want to be for learning. Now, this is Chalk Street. We have a website, www.chalkstreet.com, where we list all our courses. We also have an Android app where you can install. Sorry, I'll go really fast. Okay, it's 2 minutes.
We're already at 5 o'clock.
So do I have 2 more minutes? Or?
Yeah, you have 2 minutes, I'll give you extra 2 minutes.
Okay. So we are productizing knowledge, recorded video-based lectures, so it's not live. So what we do is, if you're good at Excel, we make an Excel course, you record the videos, you give it to us, we put the video on cloud, we sell it. Now, that's very bluntly put, but we have a very good learning platform where it's not just videos, we have discussions on it, we have tests, assignments, and all reference files and everything. And we have a thriving content around it. And we have built a platform which includes a lot of engagement as well, right? And it's a marketplace platform, it's C2C. It's not just to learners, we also empower anybody who's good at something to teach. So it's a C2C platform. And we have a lot of localized content. We have languages, we have courses in different Indian languages. And the content is also very relevant. It's, you're not learning from somebody who doesn't understand how things happen in India. For example, if you're learning soft skills, you learn soft skills that is applicable for India. This is a team. So Venkat and Rajesh are co-founders of a startup called FACE, Focus Academy for Career Enhancement. They're into placement training. They've been around for about 7 years now. And Tyag, Raj, and I joined these guys, and that's pretty much the core team of Chalk Street. Our business model, like I said, is a marketplace. We take a commission for all the courses that we sell. So whoever is the teacher gets the all the revenues, and we take a commission of it. Our commission will range from 10% to 50%, depending on who does the marketing and who does, you know, certain services. Okay, size of the market, everything. This is an important slide. This is where I want to probably spend the 1 minute I have. So a couple of things. Range of needs, right? Now, the way we see it, a Khan Academy is kind of K-12, right? A Coursera is into formal education. The range of needs that we want to cover, like I said, we want to be the Wikipedia for learning, right? Which means we want to have courses on pretty much everything, right? So the range of needs that we cater to is a lot more. And the local context that we have, catering to India specifically, I think our contextual relevance is also very high. So that is the area where we are. I think we are uniquely placed to attack that particular portion of the market. These are some examples of what I just said. For example, if you wanted to learn some basic music, right? I'm somebody who wanted to learn some music, not to sing, but just to appreciate how much of a genius Rahman is, right? For that, I just need to spend 3 hours, 4 hours on a video lecture, which I think is good. Probably pay 100, 200 bucks for it, and I want to learn. So there are a lot of these kind of lateral needs. For example, Selenium is a hot thing now, and I want to learn the basics of Selenium, probably spend 300 rupees, 2 hours, learn some basics of Selenium, HTML5, so on and so forth, right?
To unfortunately stop you.
Yeah.
So I have one question, and I think I'll throw up to the audience for another question. So what are your current milestones for 2016? And how do you plan to achieve them?
Right. So we launched in about August 2015 out of beta. And in the last 5-6 months, this is what we have. Currently, we have about 200 courses on a variety of topics. We have 100 plus authors, 40,000 users. 500 of them are paid users. We also have free courses, by the way. So a lot of free courses. That is why 40,000 users and 500 paid course subscribers. And 40 of them have repeated. They bought 2 courses. Now, for the next year, we are looking at getting 100,000 users will be the next milestone. That we won't wait till the next year. Probably in the next 3-4 months, we want to hit that first milestone. And that is when I think we'll also be ready for funding. Now, we are looking at raising funding, and that will be our landmark to get funding as well. That is when we, and other numbers will also move. And that's when we think we'll be ready.
Thanks. So I have one question from the audience. Anuj?
I couldn't look at the slide on the market size, but education as a market size is considered huge. But have you done a very specific numbers on what is your understanding of the market you are trying to cater, and what percentage of that will you achieve over the next, say, 2 years or so?
No. Have we done proper research on exactly what is the market size that we can cater to? Specifically, no. But overall market size in education, as the slide said, would be about 40 billion over the next 3 to 4 years, out of which there are a few players that are running, like Simply Learn is one company that's kind of doing well in India. They are into live learning, where there is a lot of certification formal learning. What we are trying to do is a bit more informal kind of learning, where people just want to pick up basic skills on a variety of topics. For that, we haven't put specific numbers into it yet.